Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of 6th year students who are graduating this year, I would like to take this opportunity to welcome you all here to the Cláiste, and I hope you enjoy today's celebration. As you know, this is the curtain closing for our time in the Cláiste. It is a very special time for us all, as it's the final time we will all be together in unity. This is a huge stepping stone in our lives as we all head in different directions, but all remain connected by our time here in the Cláiste. Today is a very special day for us graduates. Today allows us the opportunity to join in celebration of prayer, song and thanks to our friends, families and teachers and all who have been invaluable in our time in the Cláiste. Today we celebrate our friendships. We hope and pray that these bonds of friendship carry with us into the many challenges ahead. We hope to always truly value our friendships. Now I ask you all here to join us in celebration of prayer and give thanks to the Lord for the gift of our time here in the Cláiste.
Love one another warmly as Christian brothers and sisters, and be eager to show respect for one another. Work hard and do not be lazy. Serve the Lord with a heart full of devotion. Let your hope keep you joyful, be patient in your troubles, and pray at all times. Share your belongings with your needy fellow Christians, and open your homes to strangers. Ask God to bless those who are happy. Weep with those who weep. Have the same concern for everyone. Do not be proud, but accept humble duties. Do not think of yourself as wise. If someone has done you wrong, do not repay them with wrong. Try to do what everyone considers to be good. Do everything possible on your part to live in peace with everyone. This is the word of the Lord.
I will come to you in the silence. I will lift you from all your voice. I claim you as my choice. Be still and know I am here. I am hope for all who are hopeless. I am eyes for all who long to see. In the shadows of the night, I will be your light. Come and rest in me. Do not be afraid, I am with you. I have called you each by name. Come and follow me. I will bring you home.
For us in our lives, this means our lives are marked forever by those who we meet, the friendships we make and the love we experience, the reconciliations and quarrels, the works we have tried to do together, for each other and for those that are less fortunate. All this has given us is something that will last, long after we've forgotten the marks for our exams. We remember the friendships, the time of growth, the fun, the laughter and the jokes. We remember how we helped each other grow as men and women in faith, in hope and in love. May what we have done in this place be given in many other ways in our lives.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "This is my commandment, love one another as I have loved you. A person can have no greater love than to lay down his or her life for his or her friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I shall not call you servants anymore, because a servant does not know his master's business. I call you friends because I have made known to you everything I have learned from my Father. You did not choose me. No, I chose you, and I commissioned you to go out and to bear fruit. Fruit that will last, and then the Father will give you anything you ask him in my name. What I command you is to love one another." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Those words of Jesus are very intimate words. They were spoken by Jesus on the night before he left this world, and they were spoken to his closest friends, the people who had become his followers and his disciples. And he summed up everything that practicing religion should be about. He said to them, love one another. And that is at the heart of all religious belief, that we should love one another, have concern for one another, and look after one another. During this last year, we've been called to look after one another in a very special way. We all had to make sacrifices, and you undoubtedly made them with a very odd school year. All of us made sacrifices for the sake of others. For us, it was a practical experience of learning to love one another. We gave up things we would have liked to do for the safety and the good of others. And that is love, caring for others, looking after them, sometimes putting their interests before our own. Today you are preparing to leave school and to begin a new phase in your lives. I hope that that new phase will be a happy one for you, whether you're going to college, going into a job, whatever you're going to do, I hope it will be good. And I wish you all the very best for the rest of your lives. I hope you'll always look back on your time in care at school as a happy time, a joyful time, and above all, a time that prepared you for life. I'm Father Peter Cullen, and I'm the priest in charge at St. Mary's in Care. So as well as wishing you a very happy and good life, I want to express the hope that during your life, you will come to know your Creator, Almighty God. If you're a baptized Christian, do this by coming to know Jesus. If you're of another faith, do it by following the precepts of your own faith, because all of us have paths to God, and there are many, many different paths to God, and all of them are valuable, and all of them lead us ultimately to the one place, to be in God's presence forever.
We pray for our friends, family, and all in our local community who are sick at this time. May they make a complete recovery. We ask the Lord to keep us safe from illness as we head into the next chapter of our lives. We also remember all who have died, especially those who you have known and loved, and all who have played a special part in our lives. We thank you for the times they have shared with us. May those precious memories remain with us until we meet in heaven. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray with love and gratitude for our parents, guardians, and families who have supported us and encouraged us during our school years. Thank you, God, for the teachers and all who have worked with us in the Colossia over the years. Through their dedication and concern, they have prepared us to face the challenge of the world. Help us to continue to grow in confidence and knowledge. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Lord, we remember the friendships, the times of growth, the fun, the quarrels, the laughter, and the jokes during our years in the Colossia. As we stumble our way through life, we ask that each of us continue to be blessed with great friends. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Lord, we call to you to support and guide us on our future journey through life. Graduation is not the end, it is the beginning of new adventures. With your guidance, may all of us graduates experience much good luck and success in all we do. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for peace, comfort, good health and happiness for all our children as they head off into the world. May we share such joy and happy times with them as they journey through life. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Finally, Lord, we pray for all here present. We pray for those who have helped us to live life to the full and to flourish as men and women in faith, hope and love.
May we have the strength to embrace each day as it provides its own gifts and challenges for each one of us. May we continue to grow in friendship and support one another each day of our lives. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Hello to you all, the graduating class of 2021. Congratulations. Well, what can I say to you all? The final couple of years have been a very eventful time for you all. But take heart, you succeeded in completing it, the leaving certificate, and all this during a pandemic. You should be very proud of yourself. It was no mean feat. I would like at this point to acknowledge your families and the school staff within the Coláiste, as they've been a great source of support for me throughout my role as your year head. The theme of your graduation is, graduation is not the end, it's the beginning, and no truer words have been spoken. This is the beginning of a more independent you. You will be making choices which will affect your future. Barack Obama has said, you and you alone are the only person who can live the life that can write the story that you were meant to tell, and how true he was. Throughout your years of school, you've made new friends, developed new skills, and discovered new things about yourself. But this will also be the case as you journey throughout life. Each day will bring new joys, new worries, new hopes, new experiences, new people. And all of these will impact on you and the life that you lead. I've been asked to give you a few words of my wisdom on moving forward throughout life. Firstly, I would make sure that I would surround myself with positive people who always have your back and will always tell you the truth, no matter how difficult that is. Secondly, you've got to find out what you love. And that is as true for your work as it is for your personal life. Your work is going to fill a large part of your life, and the only way to be truly satisfied is to do what you believe is great work. And the only way to do great work is to love it. And if you don't know what that is, don't worry, you will find out. Keep looking. Don't settle. And as with all matters of the heart, you'll know when you find it. On a personal note, it's been a pleasure to be your year ahead and to get to know you better as individuals and not just as students sitting in front of me in the classroom. I wish you every success and joy in the future. Work hard, more importantly, be kind, and amazing things will happen for you. Take care, good luck.
Tosi marmach mar dalti bioga sekeid blin, kusule pesh kaale. Eg bonu kargis agus eg togal naskana. Fu yeru na dara blina, vi na naskana shin snaiha. Vi ar nefragas faig tagin, agus shin asata eg teortoraig, ar na dushlan lehula. An shin an trio blin, skruduha lewar agus dadair, ni rev moran auma agin, e daire don spri. Vi mar regan shin don inda blin, con ar skia ligant, hoga mar aig ar dushlan nua, agus hanig ar dreha agus ar galiachti is machafar. Hogan kuga blin, a rua mora lesh. Clacama lesh le mishnach agus nart, agus shin asata e pandemi dar nasiunta an coronavirus. An shin, hanig an sheo blin, agus shin an sheo an ish, einta e gargis. Hogan sheo blin, suiv de fru lesh, sel na sola de fru l gan daur. Hastigun ara haurt da keila, mar a deran sian focal ar scaha céile mar an na dine. Is fir an sian focal sin gan éine go im blina. Hog an saura deran na dine glasála leis. Post part aimsra ag sylvaol aragad agus ag dain of planned an saura. E mi fóhar blat no mead mar félacán brívra. Réig con dolig leic le a rach dí nua. Ní deara e aira e seo ach an tús.
We started out as little first years, meeting lots of new people, forging friendships and building bonds. By second year, the ties were knotted. We gained our independence as we faced many challenges. Third year brought exams, books, learnings and not much time for fun. By TY, we were ready to relax, face new things, take on new challenges and find the best qualities in ourselves.
Fifth year brought a year of change. We embraced courage and resilience as we faced the might of an international pandemic. So sixth year arrived, here we are, reunited in friendship. Sixth year brought different settings, different school life, and we needed to look out for one another. Summer brings us to the end of lockdown, into a cocoon of part-time jobs, saving money and making plans for our future. In September, we emerge as vibrant butterflies, ready to embrace our new adventures. Graduation is not the end, it's the beginning.
Lord God, we ask your blessing on these young people as they begin their lives in their adult world. Be at their side, guiding them on their challenging road ahead. May they find friends who will walk beside them, opportunities that will challenge them and reward them, love that will comfort them in the darker moments of life's journey.
May the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in this knowledge and love of God and of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. May the Lord bless you and keep you. Amen. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. Amen. May he look upon you with kindness and give you peace. Amen. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace and spread the light of Christ. So God bless you and have a nice life.
Good afternoon to all those watching. I'd like to welcome you all here today and a big congratulations to all who completed the Leaving Cert in recent weeks. To those of you who took predict grades, a lucky escape. The theme for today's Class of 2021 celebrations is that graduation is not the end, it is the beginning. It's great to see we have all made it here today. I bet most of us could have never imagined this day. I hope everyone is comfortable in their seat at home with a cup of tea in hand. If we could all take ourselves back to our first day in Colostia, we can see ourselves, small, brazen and petrified. We arrived at the doors of Colostia with a new leader at its helm, the doors as new to him as they were to us. The name Mr. Creedon whispered around the halls as a willing replacement to the mighty Miss Finnegan Burke. Looking back, I wonder did he realise what he was getting himself into. As his first year group, we gave him a run for his money over the years, no doubt. However, if it wasn't for his great leadership and advice, we wouldn't be here today. He's been by our side from day one, supporting us through our disappointments and celebrating our achievements. He has always been fighting in our quarter, sometimes to his detriment, no doubt.
Over the last 6 years in the Cloister, we have many successes ranging from sport to music to debating. Beginning with sport, our girls' team have won and competed in various competitions. They won two Munster finals, they became finalists in a futsal competition in Tallaght in 2015, and won two county football finals with the Cloister. Some of the girls have already started their sports careers, with Robin playing for Cork City, and Shannon and Rosanna, who have recently signed for Wexford Youth's Women's Football Club, and Rosanna, who also being a member of the TIP Women's Football Team, who went on to win the All-Ireland in 2019. Don't forget us when you're famous. In regards to the boys, well, they took part. They didn't win anything, but they still took part. The boys' team took part in Munster football, basketball, and took part in a hurling blitz in second year. He never attended training, but we'll just blame that on the management. Back in first year, Clara won the junior ETB talent competition. She has also appeared in almost every musical since we started in first year. I feel the musical is Miss Barry's favourite time of the year. Maybe it's an easy way to get good exercise by chasing TYs around school like she did with us. Or maybe it's just because she gets a free bouquet of flowers at the end, who knows. The last musical to take place was All Shook Up, where Alana and Dean ultimately stole the show for reasons that will remain unsaid. At least we now know a possible couple for the Debs. On both myself and Circe's time on the senior debating team, along with Shane, Lucy, Kira and Rachel, we got through to the Munster quarterfinals. However, due to COVID, this was cancelled and we never got to compete. I'm sure we'll all miss going to Matton Point with our debates while eating McDonald's chips and drinking milkshakes and the sight of Miss Fennessy getting back on the bus with bags of shopping. We'll also miss going down to UCC and sitting in the lecture halls having serious arguments.
Thanks, Jason. Who could ever forget Miss Fennessy traipsing out of Matton Point like a Christmas tree with all the bags? And Mr. McCarthy, who has recently moved on to so-called greener pastures, a traitor, smuggling us donuts. What a wonderful experience we all had in TY. For those who managed to crawl out of bed, that is. Aptly named, we began a rapid growth and transformation, some of us maturing immensely, others not so much. As this growth within ourselves was incited, so too was our growth towards one another. Some of us reached new heights designing fashionable ensembles with, well, rubbish, as three of our creations reached the Munster finals of Junk Couture, a brilliant experience all round. Some of us gained great skills and appreciation for the wider care community, volunteering and reading in the primary schools. When Miss Wade could catch us, that is. She definitely got her steps in that year. We became very tight-knit and close, as we learned to overcome great obstacles, the biggest of which being Kirkpatrick, a less eventful and more civilised overnight stay than its predecessor. Miss Wade dragged us up by the skin of our teeth, on time of course. Poor Adam Kirk had a painful run-in with a bunch of seashells, one trip to the care dock and he was good as new. However, I'm not too sure Miss Quinn would completely agree with that statement. The trip taught us resilience, hardship and above all, teamwork, all of which have become invaluable skills in recent times. Last year, our foundations were rattled by the arrival of COVID-19. Flashback to the fear of the unknown we felt on that first September day in 2015. As the world fell on trying times, so too did our education. Left to our own devices, we can all understand that many of us struggled. We are all guilty of missing classes because we were distracted or asleep. Personally, I must apologise to my biology teacher, Miss Trehy, for the amount of time she had to kick me from out of the Teams meeting while I was conked in bed. Others amongst us may have enjoyed it, learning in the comfort of their pyjamas and slippers. I suppose it wasn't all bad. To our teachers, a huge thank you for putting up with us through the screen. We know it must have been so hard for you with all the broken mics and cameras not working. The one thing that has come out of this, however, is our ability to fight through hard times. As a year group, we remain resilient and dedicated throughout the whole experience, and for this we must commend ourselves.
Firstly, I want to thank Mr. Creedon. We are his first six-year group to complete the full 6 years. He has stood by us and helped us along our journey to today. We couldn't have done it without him. Next, I would like to thank the secretaries, Carmel and Eleanor. It was very helpful having a family member in the office, which made it very easy to go to. The work Carmel and Eleanor do behind the scenes is immense to keep the school functioning. I'd like to thank the vice principals, Mr. Delahunty and Miss Tarrant. Miss Tarrant is new to the school this year, and on behalf of us 6 years, we wish you the best of luck in the future. Also to Mr. Delahunty, who managed somehow to put up with us over the last 6 years. Anytime we had a problem that we needed sorted, we knew they could help us out. I'd like to thank our year head, Miss Shanahan. Without her this year, we simply would not have made it. Despite her initial scary image, she has always been fair and listened to us and the situation we were in and helped us along the way, especially through online learning. And for that, I want to say thank you on behalf of us all. I'd also like to thank the guidance team, Mr. Landers and Ms. O'Leary. Anytime we needed advice on either CAO or apprenticeships, they always had their doors open and gave us the best advice they could. I want to acknowledge the cleaning staff, new recruits and those who have retired, Kathleen especially. Kathleen gave us her all to make sure the school was clean and tidy and neat, and she'd done a fantastic job. Next, Paddy. If Paddy was not here, the school would simply not be able to function. Paddy has gave it his all to make sure that the grass is cut, any leak is fixed, or if anyone needed him, he made it his priority. You simply cannot do anything around the closure without Paddy. I'd like to thank our new caretakers, Martin and Lisa. I hope Paddy's training you well as you big shoes to fill. I'd like to thank Miss Wade for putting this all together and to everyone who organised this. Miss Wade has always had her door open as a school chaplain and was always happy to help us out if we needed. I want to personally thank Mr. O'Driscoll for convincing me to enter politics and join Young Fine Gael. And any questions I had, he was happy to answer. I've no doubt he'll be Taoiseach soon. Also to Miss Fennessy for teaching me the skills to debate, which I will use in the future. Last but not least, I know I speak for everyone graduating today when I say we are so grateful for the quality of teaching and teachers themselves in this school. It's quite rare to find people whose only wish is to see you succeed. The student-teacher relationship in this school is one of a kind. The teachers are willing to do all they can to help in both educational and real-life needs of their students. And although it might be hard to believe, us 6 years have the utmost respect for you, both as people and the work that you do. Therefore, we say with ultimate gratitude, thank you from the bottom of our hearts.
Just as a final word, our school days, they went by so fast, just like they told us it would. Therefore, I hope everyone watching cherished these unforgettable moments we had and shared. As some days, no matter how much we want to turn back the hands of time, we will never be able to return to secondary school. Although I'm sure we'll have a few who just can't bear the thought of leaving the cloister just yet, I wish you the best in repeating. There is a universal truth that has to be acknowledged, whether we want to or not, being that everything must come to an end. As much as I've awaited graduating from the cloister, I've never truly enjoyed goodbyes. The last day of summer holidays, the final chapter of a good book, the end with a close friend. Yet, endings are inevitable. Time continues to tick away and life continues to pass. Today is one of those days for all of us. Today we say our goodbyes to teachers, students, this school, and in some ways, part of ourselves. That being said, as it is the end of one chapter, we must begin again. We must remember we have overcome tremendous hurdles these past 2 years. We have learned invaluable life skills and qualities through online learning and the pandemic in general. These skills and qualities will see us as mature and successful young adults in whatever we venture into next. Whether that be continuing our education, apprenticeships or the world of work, there is no doubt in my mind we will be successful. As a parting message here today, we have reached the light at the end of the tunnel. We have finally done it. Wherever it is you go next, fight for what you believe in, no matter what. Tell the truth, regardless of the consequence. Even if you fall short, what better way could you have spent your time? No matter how lost you may feel, we must promise to ourselves that we will hold on to the hope in our hearts. Keep our light strong and keep our light alive. We must be greater than what we have suffered. Whether it be work, relationships, life or loss, we must keep our hope and resilience afloat. As we look metaphorically around the room, to all the people who helped us to become who we are today, and to all the people we feel as though we are saying goodbye to, I assure you we will carry a piece of each other into every single thing we do next, to remind us of who we are and how we got here, and how great we are going to be. I leave you with this. Behind you all your memories, before you all your dreams, around you all those who love you, within you all you need. Thank you.
As we approach the end of June 2021, it is my great pleasure to congratulate this year's 6 years on completing secondary education in the cloister. The last 2 years have without doubt been very challenging for everyone, but I must compliment our 6 years for being extremely cooperative and supportive of every decision the school had to take during the COVID-19 crisis that hit our country. Contrary to much of the media narrative, you as a group showed tremendous resilience and patience with the ever-evolving situations. This is a credit to you, your family and to the staff at the cloister, as everyone within the community worked well together to keep everyone safe. I have many memories of this class group, as you are my first cohort of students to complete a full secondary school cycle. Over the last 6 years, you have brought great joy and pride to the cloister, which are many fine individual and collective achievements. We've had great wins and matches, fun nights at our annual school musicals, and many fine individual group successes and competitions. These are the memories that have been missed most over the course of the last 2 years, but I hope that all of you will have fond memories of these occasions. With the Leaving Certificate now completed, you have reached that point in life where you will have to take even greater responsibility for the decisions you make in life. Opportunities will present themselves for every one of you, but you will have to be brave enough and confident enough to take them. If you choose a college course or another avenue this September, embrace the challenge and give it your best effort. Oscar Wilde stated that it is important to be yourself, everyone else is taken. And this is indeed very true, but it is crucial that you always seek out good role models, people that you can learn from, and in many cases, these people are very close to you. You are now a past pupil of the cloister, but do not forget that our door will always be open. Be proud of the school you attended, as I am very proud of the role the school has played in preparing you for society as a young adult. Please mind yourselves, be wise to the temptations of alcohol, drugs and gambling that are now affecting many young people. You have made it through primary and secondary school. I salute you and I look forward to hearing about your life journeys in the coming years.
I always knew this day would come. We'd be standing one by one with our future in our hands. So many dreams, so many plans. I always knew after all these years. There'd be laughter, there'd be tears, but never thought I'd walk away with so much joy, but so much pain. And it's so hard to say goodbye. But yesterday's gone, we gotta keep moving on.
ahead.